We know that Millennium Films recently announced that Bryan Singer was brought on to direct their Red Sonja movie. For obvious reasons, that was meant with a ton of outrage and backlash and any kind of negative term you could throw at that situation. And now today, per Deadline, Red Sonja has been put on the back burner and Singer's involvement is in doubt. So production on this one was supposed to begin this year, but now clearly that is not going to happen. First question I have for you, Roka, is how do you interpret this story? Is the fact that it's being put on the back burner a sure sign that Singer is out, even though that's not confirmed in this report?
Hell yes. And I think it's time, as we talked about when we were on Movie Talk, I think last week, it's time. This is all political games that they're playing now as a studio. We're going to put it in the back burner, then we're going to quietly let Bryan Singer go, then probably bring in a female director and take this thing over for PR purposes, and hopefully, maybe, because they actually think this is a good director to take over the property and the way they should go. But I think absolutely it means Bryan Singer is out. I don't think the property's dead. I think there's still interest in Red Sonja. Not sure how much interest, but certainly for a $10 million, $15 million, $20 million budget movie, I think Red Sonja is worth the chance you take. But Millennium Films, I think, you know, they were being a bit standoffish when people were upset about the eye, and I found that to be really
an understatement.
Yeah, it was. They were jerk faces. Let's just say they were jerk faces for how they reacted to it.
Tone down the language.
I apologize. You know, and that to me bothered me on so many levels. Because look, I know you're a studio. You start swaggering around if you want, but people still got to come to your movies, and people aren't going to come to your movies if you're a jerk face. So I think the way they responded to it, maybe they learned a lesson here. The fact that they put on the back burner tells me they're walking back their comments, at least with their actions. So this is all around a good development. Singer should be buried and done with in this town. Go off and do something else somewhere else. There's enough directors. We just kicked around a bunch of directors for the possible Trench movie. There's a bunch of directors that are available to work in this town who can do a great job with this piece. And it, as I said before, it's not like Singer has a perfect record as a director. He has messed up a lot of franchises with his direction. So
I do think this is a sign that Singer is definitely out as well. But the one thing about this story in particular that gives me pause, and you know, I know nothing about the conversations behind the scenes. I'm just trying to interpret the story that was given to me today. My bigger fear is that, yes, I think it's a good thing for the property overall if they get rid of him and go look for someone else. But the way that I read this story was not necessarily them understanding that what they did was wrong,
right?
But rather trying to defend themselves, then running into a brick wall of realizing nobody out there is going to want to work with them on this project. And then they were left in a position where they had no other choice but to push pause and ultimately ditch him and find someone else. And I don't really like things playing out that way. And if that is the case, then my bigger fear for Red Sonja as a property, and something that we've been talking about its big screen potential for years now, will never happen. Because I do wonder if there are people out there who are now looking at Millennium Films and they're like, I don't like the way that they operate, so I don't want to work with them anymore.
I obviously, this is just one person and one thing that I saw online, but I did notice today Lexi Alexander, people kept saying, get Lexi Alexander, get Lexi. She's like, I don't want that. I don't, stop telling me about this job working with people who didn't get it from the start. I don't want to work with that. So I think you are very much onto something.
So do you think that this Red Sonja movie is ever going to happen, or because they have it, they have the rights to it, are we just dead in the water until the rights lapse?
Oh, gosh. You know, I could see it still happening, but not this year.
Yeah.
You know, I think that projects like this don't tend to just go away. Eventually it'll resurface again. But it could be a rights lapsing situation where it resurfaces at another studio eventually. I don't think the project is dead, though.
That is my hope at this point, is that it goes somewhere else.
Yeah, I'd be surprised if any A-list actress or burgeoning A-list actress ever takes this on at this point. And you don't want, if you want this thing to survive, the last thing you want is a C-movie or B-movie actress taking this thing over. It won't get the buzz that you want it to get and the message that it wants to send. I know Brigitte Nielsen did it in the 80s. That was essentially a B-movie actress at the time. But like, this is something you want to build up. And if you hire someone like Singer, it's because you think you've got something really powerful here to deliver. So to me, let this thing either lapse or give it some time and then maybe come back with a better presentation and someone will take a chance on it.
The other possibility is that, like, if Millennium Films doesn't have a lot of other things going on in development right now, this could be pushed through anyway and end up one of those situations you just described, like a B, C actor and just kind of disappears.
Actors want to work. If it's a chance to be a lead, people will forgive their morals. People will like look over their morals with a chance to further their career. We've seen this happen a number of times over the decades. So
an unfortunate reality for something that was destined to be a franchise and could have been a star-making vehicle for some wonderful, either already established actor or just an up-and-comer. Mm-hmm. So that is a bummer. Hopefully they course correct with this one.